Let's make some terrain. What you're looking at is a closed polyline, just made with the rectangle command, to suggest a property that's 60 feet by 100 feet. And I'm going to create some topography for this. I'm going to start, zoom out a little bit, by creating some splines. I'm going to create a spline out here, outside the property line, and I'm going to create another one inside the property line. And maybe another one inside the property line. Let's make a flatter portion of the property here. And let's introduce a little bit more complexity. Whoop, too much. That brings up a good point. When you're drawing these splines, they need to be 2D, so you probably want to turn your O-snaps off. And let's do that. And let's do that. And you'll notice I'm taking the contours outside the property line. That's important for what I want to eventually accomplish with them. And that's adequate. So what I'm going to do now is change the elevation. If I go into an isometric view, you can see that all of these objects are on a flat plane. I need to give them some elevation. So I will do this in different ways. I can use the Z constraint axis if I want to. Type in maybe 2 feet. We'll make contours every 2 feet. Take the next one. Move this one up maybe 4 feet. Take this one. Move it up maybe 6 feet. This one. Move it up 8 feet. This one. Move it up 9 feet. Whoops. One more foot, let's go every 2 foot. This one, move it up a total of 10 feet. I want to make certain I move into the Z direction only. Let's grip select that again. Oh, come on, Gizmo, there you go. 10 feet, this one here. The other way you could do this, of course, is with a simple move command. And if you're in either polar or ortho mode, you can drag upwards in the Z direction and type in the distance you want to go. And 14 feet. Okay, so now, if we orbit upward, we should be able to see that all those contours have different elevations, and in fact, they do. Next thing we're going to do is create a loft to make the surface itself. So I will type in the loft command, or if you prefer, you can find it from the modeling panel. Loft right here. You select from bottom up or from top down, doesn't matter which way you pick it. And I'm just going to default to the standard cross sections only that you see as the default. And there is my loft. Now by default you'll probably have it checked to smooth fit. I'm going to click OK. And I have my delete object system variable set to 0, so it actually retained my original splines, you can see there. Your splines will probably disappear. The system variable for that is DELOBJ for delete object. You can see mine is set to 0 at my command line. Yours is probably set to 1. If it's set to 1, your objects are consumed in the lofting operation. But I want to copy that loft to the side a little bit and show you a couple little differences that you may want to keep in mind as you're working with your lofting objects. One is that sometimes you may find that when you have contours that are very close to each other, you may have situations where it looks like you have boulders that are popping out of the ground. That has to do with the way the lofting is approaching the splines and the normals to them. When that happens, you might want to switch from a smooth fit to a ruled fit. So you'll notice there's some options here for different fitting on the surface normals. If you change this to a ruled surface, what will happen is it essentially draws a linear loft from one curve to the next, and a linear loft from one curve to the next. And if you have sufficient contours, you'll never even really notice that in a 3D model. And in fact, that's the way a lot of digital terrain models are made, is with flat surfaces or interpolation points, if you will. And that's kind of important for some things, because if you have a surface that moves back on itself, it's not very accurate. You typically don't have overhangs on most topographic contours. But most importantly, you really won't be able to do the next trick that I'm going to show you here, and that is to create a three-dimensional solid of our site plan. So here we have our surface. That's just a lofted surface. What I'm going to do is use the command thicken, which you can find on the, here it is, right there is the thicken command. And I'll use the thicken command, select my surface, and I'm going to give it a thickness, not very much, just maybe a few inches. We'll just go 8 inches thick here. So now you can see I have a surface that is in fact thickened. It's an actual 3D solid now. So now I can do an interesting thing with it. Let me switch to wireframe so you can see what I'm about to do here. You can see that this is my original property line here. What I'm going to do is use an extrude command, select my property line, and I'm just going to extrude it up a huge amount. Doesn't really matter too much. And I'm going to move this down a little bit into the Z direction. And now what I'm going to do is use the subtract command and subtract from this object, this object. Now, this object here didn't disappear because I have my delete object system variable set to 1. I'm going to erase it though now. And you can see that in fact right here there's a gap where these two surfaces thickened surface sliced through this particular rectangular 3D solid. Now I can use the command separate from the solid editing panel. Select either one of these and I can simply erase the top one. Go back to maybe conceptual, and now you can see there is my actual topography for my site with some thickness on the base that I could then use for placing my building or objects on my property. Pretty simple, not too difficult to do, and it works well. If you keep in mind that if you have issues, you might want to switch to a ruled surface instead of a smooth fit surface. That's it. Hope that helped. Enjoy using AutoCAD.